لله رب العالمين الحمد لله ذي الملك والملكوت ذي العزة والجبروت الحمد لله ذي الفضل والكرم ذي القدرة والنعم الحمد لله حي قيوم لا ينام عزيز لا يضام قهار لا يرام وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون or you will believe fear Allah as it should be feared and then not accept on the state of Islam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the most merciful bestow on us the gift to thy state of Islam. Allahumma ameen ya rabbal alameen. Amma ba'd. The base of every relationship with the dear ones is the communication. And the heart of the relationship, when it's healthy, it's way to have good communication. And in this way, that someone needs to reflect on his relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Well, someone will say, he'll ask himself or herself, what is my relation with Allah? We need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in everything we need, in everything in our life. That when we turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's like we turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in one direction, in one sense. Is that not thinking that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you're building in the relation, a mutual relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we do with the dear ones. And therefore, there's kind of etiquette of takhatub, etiquette of how to communicate. Because the supplication of the dua, you make the dua. But you not consider how someone he is also with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that mutual relation. And this relationship is really the sense and the heart of the ubudiyyah, the servitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because we have relationship with our families, with our children, with our spouses, with our friends, with our relatives. But when it comes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's like a relationship only on time of need. We pray because we need to pray, and we ask Allah because we need to, He's the only one who answers us. But there's no that relationship based on the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, based on a mutual reverence, based on a mutual, not mutual that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but being shakur to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as it is an obligation on us to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So there's the relation to consider the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this communication. And the best way to draw this great lesson from the Quran, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala report for us how the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they ask in dua, in full humility, with great humbleness, and with great haya, glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But do we have in mind that someone, he met Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directly live, with no obstacle, with no translator? And it is in the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reporting for us fresh, vivid, certain scenes from the Day of Judgment, who help us first to reflect on those ayat, and then to see how in our life today, we can really have those etiquette to build this communication. Communication based on friendship. Look, one of the highest level of the servitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah called it khilla. And we call it Ibrahim alayhi salam, called وَاتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ إِبْرَاهِيمَ خَلِيلًا. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, also he is khalil ur-Rahman. And this khilla that we're talking about is only come from the direction of the servant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or from mutual relationship. The khilla is a friendship, and it's a high level of servitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in this amazing ayah in Surah Al-Ma'idah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described for us a way of communication that is really astonishing, that also is fearful. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قَالَ بَعْدَ عُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ يَوْمَ يَجْمَعُ اللَّهُ الرُّسُلُ فَيَقُولُ مَاذَا أُجِبْتُمْ. The day when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will gather the messengers, the messenger, the best of the creation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala selected for His message. He will tell them, what have you been answered? مَاذَا أُجِبْتُمْ. What the people that I sent you to, they answered you. It then they were there, calling people, listening to their answer. قَالَ مَاذَا أُجِبْتُمْ.
what will be in the Day of Judgment, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reporting to us into the Quran in the Surah Al-Ma'idah, قَالُوا لَا عِلْمَ لَنَا لَا عِلْمَ لَنَا. We don't have no knowledge, Ya Allah. The messenger being sent to their people, they do not have any knowledge. They say, لَا عِلْمَ لَنَا Ya Allah. إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ عَلَّامُ الْغُيُوبِ. This is a way of relationship, communication. What a great thing that we can extract from this ayah. قَالُوا لَا عِلْمَ لَنَا. Subhanallah, لَا عِلْمَ لَنَا. It's like they were in there. No. But the scholar of the tafsir, rahimahullah ta'ala, go deeper and see into the understanding of this ayah and see what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the companion of Allah ta'ala alayhim understood this ayah. قَالُوا لَا عِلْمَ لَنَا. It's like because they were so terrified to be standing before Allah. لَا عِلْمَ لَنَا. Being terrified, you cannot even speak. And this is, give us the idea when you stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Think of حَالُ الْمَطَارِ. حَال, the state of standing before Allah. Messenger of Allah, in a live meeting, they could not speak. They cannot recall even what happened. لَا عِلْمَ لَنَا. By reverence and greatness to the great sublimity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَا عِلْمَ لَنَا. The other understanding when they say لَا عِلْمَ لَنَا, we don't have no knowledge. Because Allah has the whole knowledge. So our knowledge compared to yours is nothing, Ya Allah. It's full humility and humbleness. And also submission fully to Allah. لَا عِلْمَ لَنَا. And it is here, you find in the khitab, in this type of communication that we learn from, you're standing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, dignifying His greatness, which need to have the fear in our heart, because subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has the power, and we don't have. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has the power to destroy us all, and to cast in hellfire if He will. And we don't have any power to harm Allah. قَالَ وَلَا تَبْلُغُ ضُرِّي. You cannot even get to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second thing, when you call Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, remember that He is al-ghani, you وأنت الفقير. He is the all-rich. He is the all-independent. He has everything. He doesn't need us. And we are the poor ones. So when the messenger alayhi salam standing before Allah in the Day of Judgment in a very terrifying day, everyone is trembling. When they see hellfire, everyone will go on his knees. They will say, لَا عِلْمَ لَنَا. Imagine you are today and you try to recall those senses, those feelings, those thoughts, just to be with Allah, to see how glory and how subhanahu wa ta'ala, sublime Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it will change. Therefore, the communication with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala started with one fact, is to consider the maqam that you are standing before Allah. You're not talking to anyone else. You're not talking to your parents. Parents, you have to respect them, but Allah is different. You're not talking to an elder that you respect. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is different, is higher. And this is give us a glimpse of the greatness of Allah and how we should at least have the grasp, the dimension, how to stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called the angels, وَيَوْمَ يَحْشُرُهُمْ جَمِيعًا ثُمَّ يَقُولُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ أَهَؤُلَاءِ إِيَّاكُمْ كَانُوا يَعْبُدُونَ. It's amazing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will call the angels. And He say, all the angels, indeed they used to worship you. People, they used to worship you. Look at the first thing what they said. قَالُوا سُبْحَانَكَ. This is the second quality or characteristic of the way of the etiquette in the communication of with Allah. سُبْحَانَكَ. Be exalted, Ya Allah. إِسْتَبَرُّ. Is a way that you cannot be in a state of sin. You cannot be in a way that you are fighting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to communicate with Him. قَالُوا سُبْحَانَكَ أَنْتَ وَلِيُّنَا مِنْ دُونِهِمْ وَيَوْمَ يَحْشُرُهُمْ وَمَا يَعْبُدُونَ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ فَيَقُولُ أَأَنْتُمْ أَضَلْتُمْ عِبَادِي هَؤُلَاءِ. قَالُوا سُبْحَانَكَ أَمْ هُمْ ضَلُّوا السَّبِيلَ. قَالُوا سُبْحَانَكَ أَنْتَ وَلِيُّنَا مِنْ دُونِهِمْ أَنْتَ وَلِمَا كَانَ يَنْبَغِي لَنَا أَنْ نَتَّخِذَ مِنْ دُونِكَ مِنْ أَوْلِيَاءَ. It wasn't for us to take anyone to be protector or to be deity before you, Ya Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, except than you. Therefore here, it comes the second part, which is the first, is when you stand to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, recall those messengers alayhi salam, they cannot even recall any answer. then you record the angels when they speak to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, did you do this? Say subhanahu, which means someone needs to cleanse himself, not to be in a state of sin. Remember the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the one who is traveling, and he's stretching out his hand to the sky, and he's saying, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Rab, Ya Rab, Ya Rab. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, غُذِيَ مِنْ حَرَامٍ وَمَلْبَسُهُ مِنْ حَرَامٍ وَمَأْكَلُ مِنْ حَرَامٍ فَأَنَّ يُسْتَجَابُ لَهُ. Someone is dressing in haram and eating haram and he's being nourished by the haram. How someone, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will even listen to him? And this is how the angels are teaching us. And the, anyone who's been worshipped other than Allah, they're righteous, when they come to the day of judgment, the first thing you say, subhanahu. It's like when you stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you glorify the fact that you're standing before him, and then you try to cleanse yourself from the fact that we are not really paying the whole due to Allah, not having the high esteem to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the Salihin, his name Al-Ala ibn al-Hadrami, he had this relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He had this relationship. The relationship is the way of communication to having present in your heart how glorified, how great Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That fear is not a fear to be scared, it's not a fear that take away the hope from you, it's a fear who help you to raise more and more for the good deeds. That fear of love, that fear that you don't want to be neglected by Allah, you don't want to fall from the eye of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That communication of the Torah, an internal remembrance, someone he has a friendship, intimate. You see everyone who has a phone always look, did he get any email from the people he remember or any message? That's the way how someone maintained the relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they were in a ghazu, in a unit going to join an army, and Ala ibn Hadrami was with them. And they didn't find the water. They told them, make dua for us, Ya Ala. قَالَ اللَّهُمَّ يَا عَلِيمٌ يَا حَكِيمٌ يَا عَلِيٌ يَا عَلِيمٌ. Ya Alimun, you know everything, Ya Allah. Hakimun, you have the whole wisdom. Aliyun, you have the aboveness, Ya Allah. Azimun, you are the most tremendous. And he said they walked few steps and they found the water, subhanAllah. And it was in Mafaza, which is in the Antila, the desert. And this is the maintaining of the relationship. And even they come afterward, a lake that they cannot cross. And he said, Ya Allah, he said the same thing. Ya Alimun, Ya Halimun, Ya Aliyun, Ya Azimun, and the other way, Ya Hakimun. And subhanAllah, they said they get it with their horses. And this has been narrated to see, subhanAllah, when you maintain the relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you feel that power inside. You feel like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very close to you. That's why in the one of the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, narrated by Tirmidhi, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not listen to a communication of someone when his heart is distracted. Musa alayhi salam was passing by someone, he was begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in dua. And Musa said, Ya Allah, if his hajat is what he needs, what you need with my hand, I will have given to him. فَأَوْحَى إِلَيْهِ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. Allah revealed to him, he said, Ya Musa, أَنَا أَرْحَبُ بِهِ مِنْكَ. I'm more merciful to him than you. قَالَ إِنَّ لَهُ غَنَمْ. He has flocks of sheep. قَالَ هُ يَدْعُونِي وَقَلْبُهُ إِنَّ غَنَمِ. He's calling me, but his heart is with his sheep. He's calling me and his heart in his business. He's calling me and his heart in other things. So how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be with you? You didn't build this communication. You don't have a relationship. So if someone has a real relationship, when you talk to your parents, you look at their face. You look at them, you express your love to them, you express your respect to them. But if someone calling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his heart is distracted away, therefore he will not be heard. And then that's why we said, when you glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you're standing before Allah. And then the second thing is to cleanse yourself. Cleanse yourself. Ya'qub al-Layth was one of the rulers, long time ago. And he has a sickness that no one can help him with his sickness. They told him, in your time you have one of the Salihin, Sahl ibn Abdullah. Call Sahl ibn Abdullah, he wants to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for you. When Sahl ibn Abdullah is being called, he told him, can you please make dua for me? He's the ruler, he's the emir of the town. And he's the person that was unjust. He said, I will call for you, but Allah will not answer my call. He told them why? He told them because there's oppressive people being cast in your prison unjustly. He commanded to free them all. And after he freed them, then Sahl, he made the dua. What he said? Qala ya Allah. Listen to the dua. Qala ya Allah. لقد أذقته ذلة معصيتك فأذقه عزة طاعتك وفرج عنه. Ya Allah, you have him to taste the humiliation of the disobedience. Now, Ya Allah, taste him the honor of the submission and heal him, Ya Allah. And this is what the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was teaching to Abu Bakr. When you stand, when you ask him, Ya Rasulullah, give me dua that I will say it in my in the prayer. And that was the beautiful dua. Qul Allahumma inni dhalamtu nafsi dhulman shadeeda. I have transgressed myself, dhulman kabira, great transgression, which is glorifying Allah and considering that you're not in a state of fighting Allah. Because if you are in a state of sin, Allah will not listen to you. You're not building your relationship. There's no friendship. How can be with someone friend and you're cheating on him? How can you be with a friend and you are betraying him? How can you be someone you call a friend and you gossip him? You not do good for him. So when you someone in state of sin is fighting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the situation when you say someone cleanses himself like this ruler when he made the obedience to Allah to submit and free the unjust immoral people in prison, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered the dua. The last part, which is situation that is truly in need for our all of us, in much of need, which is our situation, our reality. Sometimes we do not really describe it to Allah. We make dua, but not really reflecting our reality. We just make dua. Oh Allah, forgive us. Ya Allah, maghfirli. طيب اغفرلي, what did you do? Can you recall something that to pour it into that intention? When you have a problem, when you don't speak to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this last part, which is the description of your situation, waqi' al-hal. Because if you don't describe to Allah, if you don't express what you have, therefore you're not making this relationship, that you're failing, we are failing in our communication. A lady, she lost a kid, and she came to Imam Junaid, rahimahullah ta'ala. She said, can you make dua for me, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring me back my kid? It's based on communication. They're asking the Salihin to make dua. Why are there Salihin there? Good relation with Allah, a relation of friendship. قَالَ اِذْهَبِي وَاسْبِرِي. Go and have patience. She came back to him after 2 days. قَالَ اِذْهَبِي وَاسْبِرِي. I told you, go and have patience. The second time, the third time, the fourth time she came, she said, قَالَ يَا أُمَامِ. Don't you make dua for me? I'm at the level that my heart is melting and I cannot bear patience. He told her, go back your kid, you might find him already at home. She ran, subhanAllah, she found her. They asked her, how did you know? He said, it's in the book of Allah. أَفَمَنْ يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرَّ إِذَا دَعَاهُ. Is there someone like Allah, if there's anyone like Allah, who will answer the one in a state of necessity. He said, I told her to go have sabr. When she came at the level, high level of her sabr, that's her state of necessity, Allah will answer her dua. When she came to me and told me, I cannot, ya Imam, make dua, he told her already, Allah answered you. Go back, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered you. This is a khwani, to not make it long, just to come to a summary, it's not about you make dua to wait for the istijabah. It is building a communication with Allah. Building is a relationship. What is your relationship with Allah? How many times you talk to Allah? How many times you be saying Alhamdulillah from the bottom of your heart, meaning something, and you will be listening that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is accepting your praise? How many times you make dua into your sujood and you feel that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is listening to you? That is the relation. So it's not a relation of dua that you call and then that's it, you're waiting for the answer. Because in the hadith that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, in the hadith which is narrated, that someone will be making dua with love. قَالَ يَدْعُ اللَّهَ وَهُوَ يُحِبُّهُ. He asking Allah with love, this relation, this strong relation. فيقول يا جبريل أخل لعبدي حاجته. يا جبريل, delay the answering of the call of my servant. Why? قال فإني أحب أن أسمع صوته. Because I love to listen to his voice. Now if you think of it, what will be better for you? For to have what you ask him for, or for Allah to love to listen to your voice? Why? Because in the other hadith, or in the same continuation of the hadith, he said, when someone Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't love, and he will be calling Allah, hey, to listen to his voice. He said, Ya Jibreel, give him what he wants. Therefore, the answer of dua is in fact test and comes in a form of punishment, because it's going to be tried for him and it's going to be a regret for him in the day of judgment. And one of the great scholars, his name Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Qattar, he saw in his dream the greatest subhanahu wa ta'ala, قال إلهي أدعوك ولم تجب. He said, Allah, Ya Ilahi, oh my Lord, I'm being called to you, but I didn't get any answer. قال يا يحيى إني أحب أن أسمع صوتك. يا يحيى, I love to listen to your voice. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to build the communication, not a simple dua, without thinking of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what He thinks of us. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us all. نقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه الله. بسم الله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى أما بعد. Three facts or characteristics in the etiquette of building communication with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leading to a true friendship. And if you are in the friendship with Allah, therefore Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you that peace of mind, give you that tranquility. Nothing from the external will hurt you, because you know that Allah has power over it. You know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if He decree for you what you already have, that is the best for you. Therefore, work to be close to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we say the first point, consider you standing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like the messenger. The second point is to cleanse yourself, at least ask forgiveness and acknowledge our sins before we address to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The third point is communicate with Allah with the true, your own reality, not in the space, someone spacing out, making dua without thinking what he really needs, without thinking what he really has as objective. And the last thing we say, all of us be Muslims, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. And this dua, or in this hadith, is being narrated that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying in the Athar, and it says that he's being narrated by Bukhari, not in the Sahih, but in Tariq al-Adab. He's saying that a man, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is angry at him. He's making dua. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala turned away from him. Again, he's still making dua. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala turned away from him. And he's still making dua. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala turned away from him. And then he keep making dua, and then Allah turned to his angel. He said, he's insisting, and he didn't call anybody else except me. Witness that I answered his dua. Our way out is to keep knocking the door. Our way out is to insist. And by insisting, we're building the communication. And by improving the communication, we have a healthy relationship. And by that, we'll be firm on the path of the pleasure of Allah. That's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أن يرزقنا الطاعة. واجعلنا من قوم تحبهم ويحبون. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا أجمعين. اللهم آتي تقواها يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم آتي نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها. أنت وليها ومولاها. اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين يا علي يا حكيم يا عظيم يا رب العالمين اغفر لنا ذنوبنا أجمعين وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين وآخر الصلاة والحمد لله.